replay. One young man is dead at the scene. Another person, a woman, was taken to the hospital. She was not shot. Her condition is unknown. I want to walk you through the violent scene, really just unfolding behind me. This happened not long ago, within the hour. If you look behind me, you can see the bus stop. The glass there on that bus shelter has been shattered by those gunshots, and you can see on the ground the evidence, more evidence of all that gunfire. Many, many shell casings. Witnesses that we spoke to here on the scene counted at least 13 gunshots that rang out this morning before noon. We understand from witnesses that a person drove by, fired some shots at some people waiting at that bus stop. That young man was killed. And that woman was taken to the hospital. She had fallen, and paramedics rushed to get her to safety. I want to also walk you through the scene right now. We understand during the confusion, if you can stay with us right here, that a person actually called 911. The man who was driving this Saturn right here, you can see his bumper is damaged right there. We understand that he drove by, saw what happened, and then actually backed into a PAT bus that was driving by so that he could stop and call 911 and render aid if he needed to. There were people on that bus who came very, very close to the violence.
Heard the bang, 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 like loud noises, like, you know, and fire.
And then what did you see?
Just him lying down and the woman down, but she was still like rolling and shaking, hanging on for life.
We do understand from witnesses, also from police, that they may have been tracking the vehicle that the killers were in. We have no word right now of any arrests in this case. Just wrapping up one more time in Wilkinsburg, a young man has been shot and killed. Another woman, a person taken to the hospital in this case, and police are looking for the killers. This is the third homicide, the third murder in this area in Wilkinsburg within the past 2 weeks. Reporting live, I'm Shannon Perron, Channel 4 Action News.